Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today I am bringing to you guys a mini beauty and fashion haul, maybe? I think, yeah. Okay, just give me a sec. Alright, so I actually went shopping last Thursday and today, and I wanted to show you guys what I got. Now, there isn't a lot, just saying. I'll start with fashion haul. I went to H&M this morning. I actually was at Macquarie Center because I took the driver's knowledge test so I can get my learner's license, and I passed. And so I'll be learning how to drive here in Australia. I mean, I drove in the Philippines, not so much. And it's been a while since I have been behind the wheel. So I intended to start over and make sure that I'm not going to be endangering the lives of myself and others as I'm driving. So I'm definitely gonna take maybe 10 lessons or so just to get my confidence back into driving. But while I was there, as you do, I went around the mall and I went into H&M because H&M always pulls me in, and they had a sales section. So I got, in case you didn't know, while it's summer in the northern hemisphere down here in Australia, in the land down under, it's actually winter. So I got two knits. Okay, this one here, these are both in size medium, which is a little bit too big for me, to be honest, but this is the color and the material of the first one. This was $20. Okay, and it's just a regular high neck knit, and I just love the color, so I got it. I could have gone down to a small, but I always like my knits to be quite chunky and big. Like this one that I'm wearing right now, I'll show you. Yeah, it's a little bit big. All right. And then the other one that I got, I just like the color of this one. It's a little bit like, it's blue and violet at the same time. Blue-violet, I guess. Again, it's high neck. But this one is more of a dress. Like if I stand up, it goes all the way to almost my knees. So I'm thinking that I could pair this with tights, boots, and maybe cinch it in with a belt or something like that. So I got this. And I really like it. So they're both in medium size. Like I said, I could have gone for a small, but they weren't, they didn't have that size in the sale. So I didn't really wanna, it wasn't a big deal. Anyway, now moving on to beauty, I got from Lush a repurchase already of the King of Skin Body Butter, which I use in the shower. I'm not going to show you it anymore, but what I'll do is I'll insert a photo in here because I don't want to open them since I'm not going to be using them just yet. I still have some in the shower. But one is the King of Skin Body Butter, and its base is cocoa butter and shea butter. This one is called a scrubby, and if you look at it, it looks like a bee. And it says it's got fair trade organic cocoa butter, fair trade shea butter, ground coconut shell for the scrubby bits, and honey. So that's, and actually ground almonds as well. So those are the scrubbies that are in here. And they're all like biodegradable, so they're good for the environment. I'm addicted to bubble tea, or I think most people call it boba. This is taro flavor. Anyways, also while my friend was at on holiday in Singapore, I got from her, I asked her to buy this for me, the Innisfree Perfect UV Protection Essence Water Base. This is what it is. And this has got hyaluronic acid on it, which is what I intend to use now that it's winter, because winter tends to dry my skin out. I do have the other one that is oil-free matte, so that can be the one that I use for the summer. And I think this was like $22. Okay. Oh, sorry, I forgot to mention how much these are. The King of Skin was $12.95, and the Scrubby is $15.95. They're a little bit pricey, but at least I don't get like extra packaging that's just gonna clutter and add to pollution in the environment. Speaking of too much packaging, okay, I ordered for the first time from Juvia's place, And I got the Zulu palette. This is just the box. Look at how pretty that is. Okay. So I got the Zulu palette because I was like going onto the website. I went to the website and they were offering international shipping already to Australia for only $7, which I think is very, very affordable considering how expensive it is to ship stuff here in Australia. So I got it. I got the Zulu palette. This is what it looks like. I actually used it today for this look that I'm wearing. So that's what that looks like. I'll be inserting swatches in here as well so that you can take a look at what the shades are. And just to give you an idea, this is the look that I created with this palette today. The only two shades that I didn't end up using is this brown one here and the green in the middle. Everything I have actually used on this look. I've got the yellow in the inner corner, I've got the pink in the crease, a little bit off the orange on the lower lash line, as well as the purple. I've got this, how would you call this color? I've got that all over the lids, deepened by this green shade. And I've got this shade here as my brow bone highlight, as you can see. So I got this. But I just wanted to say that they went overboard on the packaging. I mean, I'm thankful because at least it came very, very secure, and there was no way that this could have been, this could have arrived broken, because first, it's this packaging. Then it's this sleeve of bubble wrap, and then it goes into the box that I showed you earlier, and then it was further wrapped with this kind of styro, really to absorb the shock, and then it was packaged with this box and this much, do you call it peanut styro? Yeah, like for this is the packaging. So I just thought it was a little bit too much, since I'm trying to reduce my wastage, but then when I order something from Juvia's place, it comes in such huge packaging. I don't want to complain because I'm pretty happy that my palette came in really protected, but isn't it a bit overkill? Okay, the next thing is Mirage Noir from NARS, from MAC, actually already launched here in Australia, finally. It was available online before it was available in store, but I didn't want to buy it online because one, I have to pay for shipping, and that's $10. And also I wanted to swatch it and see it for myself first. So I got not one, but two of the Mirage Noir Pearl of A Mother of Pearl Matte Face Powder. I'm not showing the other one because it's already in like my giveaway pile. I bought two because I wanted to give one away to you guys. And this is what it looks like. Isn't it gorgeous? I've actually already swatched this. So that's why some of the pink is in that gold one. And I'm wearing it on my cheeks right now. I swirled my Real Techniques blush brush on there, and that's what you're seeing on my cheeks right now. It's gorgeous. I'm gonna insert here the swatches. I've swatched them individually. And then the swatch that is closest to my wrist or to my palm is it swirled together, and as you can see, it's a beaut. Even on like my bronze skin, my tan skin, it looks pretty awesome. So I was very happy to get this. This is $46 here in Australia. I got mine from David Jones, and the extra one that I got is going to go into a giveaway box. And lastly, as I was at Macquarie Center earlier today, I stopped by the Inglot counter, and I bought an AMC gel liner, and this is in the color number 82. Okay, and let me just show you the shade. It's this, would you call this periwinkle? I don't know, because it's not blue, it's not purple. I don't even know if the camera's doing it justice. I think it is what you call periwinkle, because it's in between purple, blue, and lilac. So there. And this was actually 70% off, so I ended up only paying $9 for it there. Because I've been looking for like colored eyeliner. I've got the green one, which is number 87, and I've got the normal black one, which is number 77. I didn't put it on today. I was thinking of putting it on, but I already have like really colorful eyes anyways. And plus, well, I've got lash extensions, and I feel like if I use eyeliner, I'm gonna have to really try and remove it with an oil-based remover, and that's just not gonna help my lash extensions to stay. Yeah, so that's my mini haul for you guys. I'm definitely gonna do a review off the palette and off that face powder. Now, I can already tell you from first impressions that the pink shade in that Zulu palette is quite patchy. I didn't like that at all. And there was a little bit of fallout when I was using that sort of like aqua shimmery shade. So yeah, those are my first thoughts on those. If you want to see a full review of the Zulu palette, please leave a comment down in the comment section down below. Let me know your thoughts. If you have bought from Juvia's Place before, do you think that it is worth the hype that it's getting, or is it just overhyped? All right, and I will see y'all again in the next video. Bye.